Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm gonna walk through my skincare essentials, favorites for acne, eczema prone skin, specifically going into these colder months. And my skin type is a mixture of everything. I've never had truly perfect skin or easy skin necessarily. I broke out a lot in high school. In college it calmed down a little bit, but I would say in the past year it's definitely increased a bit more. My skin definitely breaks out due to stress. It's even to the extent where if I'm crying the next day I will have a few more zits. So again, while my skin has been pretty fickle over the past year, I do think I've found solutions to specific problems that I've been having, and I've found certain products that really work well for me. But I'm sure I'm gonna ramble way more than what I want to, so I'm just gonna jump into this and get started so this video is not 1,000 years long. So for my cleanser, this one is a fairly new purchase, but this is the Kate Somerville Eradicate Daily Foaming Cleanser. It's an acne treatment. I picked this up because my skin is continually breaking out. It's something that I would like to get on top of, and I do think that switching to this cleanser has helped me get on top of the big breakouts that I was having. So the active ingredient in this is sulfur. It's 3% sulfur, and I would say it's more of a clay-based foaming cleanser, if you will. I don't think that it strips my skin. I don't think that it leaves it more dry than it can be in the winter months. I think that this does a great job of cleaning my skin, cleaning out my pores, getting all of that gunk out, and I've really, really enjoyed it. The second part with face wash has been this guy. So this is a Bowie face cleanser. This guy's silicone, and as you can see, it's fairly soft on top. I wet my face, put a little bit of cleanser on here, and then I use this to work it into my skin for a minute. I find that any face cleanser that I use suds up a lot more with this. This guy, since it is silicone, is antibacterial, so I just rinse it off afterwards. I set it next to my sink like this, so all the water drains out. After I wash my face in the morning, I go straight into moisturizer. This is easily my favorite moisturizer that I've ever used. So this one right here is the Belief the True Cream Aqua Balm. They have two versions of this and they're packaged exactly the same. So depending on which one that you're looking for, just double check before you purchase if you are looking for the gel one, because one is a gel, one is a cream. The Aqua Balm, which I have here, is a gel consistency. It immediately soaks into your skin. It's so refreshing, and I feel like it's such a lightweight moisturizer, but it really, really moisturizes my skin. After I go with my moisturizer, I go in with my SPF. So the sunscreen that I've been loving, as most people are as well, is the Supergoop Unseen Sunscreen with SPF 40. It is broad spectrum and it says it's water and sweat resistant for up to 40 minutes. With sunscreen, there's a lot of active ingredients that skin can easily react to, so I would recommend trying out different kinds of sunscreen if you are using a separate sunscreen and finding the one that works best for you. That rounds up what I would do in the morning for my skincare. If it was nighttime, I would wash my face. After I'd wash my face, before going into my moisturizer, I use a vitamin C. Because I'm breaking out regularly, I do not have the self-control to not pick at my acne, so making sure that I'm not scarring and really healing any of those blemishes as quickly as possible is a very high priority for me. So with this vitamin C booster, it's expensive, I'm not gonna lie. This thing's like $95 for this little thing, but for $95 and for the change that I found in my skin, 100% worth it. I will be buying this again and again after I run out, but I don't think I'm gonna run out very quickly. Again, I use this every single night. I've been using it for about 2 months and I am like barely at a quarter of the way down, which is fantastic. Since vitamin C isn't a powder though, you do need to mix it with something. With vitamin C, you don't wanna mix it with certain active ingredients. So vitamin C is something that should not be mixed with your retinol, AHAs, BHAs, any other types of acid, which is commonly found in other skincare products. And I do have skincare products that have those ingredients in them, but when I do use those, I'm not using the vitamin C at the same time so that it's not too harsh on my skin, and also I'm making sure I'm getting the most out of these products, which I'm spending money on. So with vitamin C, I decided to go for a very simplistic hyaluronic acid moisturizing serum. So this is the Glossier Super Bounce. It's hyaluronic acid and vitamin B5 serum. This guy is really simple. I really enjoyed it. It's just a nice moisturizing serum. It doesn't do anything too crazy. It moisturizes my skin, and I find it to be a really great thing to mix the vitamin C powder with. So the next few items are my treatments, if you will. I don't use them all the time. I use them periodically, but I do find that they are fantastic for my skin. So The first one is a mask. This guy is the Summer Fridays Overtime Mask. It has pumpkin with vitamin A, vitamin C. It's also got some apricot seeds as well in there for that actual grainy exfoliating texture, similar to the St. Ives apricot scrub, but much more delicate. I would say the St. Ives really rips the shit out of my skin. This also has beta carotene, which is one of its active ingredients. That is a certain type of acid, which helps promote cell turnover. This mask doesn't harden, it doesn't dry, and afterwards your skin feels really smooth. I like using this mask probably once every other week, if not just when I feel like my skin is feeling a little bit clogged and congested. If I'm finding that I'm breaking out a lot more, I'll go in with a mask like this to really just try and restart my skin. But there's a fine line to walk, because if you're using an acid too often, if you're using an exfoliation too often, your skin can become very irritated, and that'll cause your skin to overproduce oil, which then will cause more breakouts because you're stripping it so often. Same thing too with this other item. So this is the TLC Framboise Glycolic Night Serum. It's by Drunk Elephant. I really love this product. I remember the first time I used it, I went into Sephora and got a sample, and I used it, and the next morning I was like, who is this person? My skin is so soft, it's so glowing, it's smooth, amazing. I got hooked and I was using it all the time. Don't do that. So this is a 12% AHA BHA blend, so that's a fairly high amount of acid. This stuff is no joke, especially if you have sensitive skin. Use it maybe once a week, once every other week. Really don't go too heavy on this. First off, this is expensive. This guy is like $90. But secondly, using something with that high of an acid content can really strip your skin, just as the other exfoliator. And then through that, you'll get the negative side of using something that's stripping, and your skin will overproduce oil, etc., etc., everything I just mentioned. I think that having acids in your skincare routine, especially if you do break out often and you do have oilier skin, is very crucial. Even if you're using them periodically, I think it is important to really clean out your skin to that level. So this next product is something that I use specifically on my cuticles, is the Weleda Skin Food. This is the small travel size version, not the big one. I use this for my cuticles. It is fantastic. I'm terrible at remembering to moisturize my hands and put things on my cuticles, so they always get super dry, super cracked. But this Skin Food is so rich. It is so thick, yet it really sinks in after you work it in for a while. So I have one of these that I keep by my bed, and I have one of these in my backpack, and I find it does a great job of keeping my cuticles very moisturized, especially because I don't do it often. Now, the next two things are for moisturizing, and I use these specifically on any spots where I get eczema. So I basically just get little patches everywhere on my body, especially when the seasons are changing. I find it flares up a lot, and when I'm stressed, I find that my eczema really flares up when I'm stressed out. So this is the First Aid Beauty Ultra Repair Cream. It's the Intense Hydration Skin Protectant. I'll take this guy and I'll put it on the spots that I have, specifically on my face. It's a cream moisturizer, but it's not so thick that it doesn't sink in. The second thing though is my holy grail skin product. My holy grail everything. I use this on everything. This is the Aquaphor Healing Ointment. This is the advanced therapy for cracked, dry, and irritated skin. This is the big one. It's a clear ointment. It's not very sexy, but I use this on everything. This is the only thing that I use for chapstick or any type of lip product. It's the only product that I've found has worked. I don't know about you guys, but I find that when I start using a chapstick, it'll work well for the first like few days. After that, my lips start to get super chapped and like really flaky, and I hate it, and I hate spending money on chapsticks, especially if I know that in a week they're probably not gonna work for me. What I did is I got the Big Daddy, and then I ordered these little silicone travel containers off Amazon. They come in a pack of three. I bought two of them, and I have these everywhere. I have one in my backpack, one in my purse. I have one next to my bed. I have one in my medicine cabinet. I have like extras in my backpack. I gave one to my friend Matt. I gave one to my brother. I just give them out to people. It's so, so good, and it's so cheap, and it is truly amazing. I could go on about it for days, guys. If you do anything after this video, please try using Aquaphor as chapstick. I will say Aquaphor has a lip treatment, and it's absolute garbage. I found it did the exact same thing that all of the chapsticks do for me. I tried it because I was like, great, hopefully it's just Aquaphor in an easier to use container. And it's not as thick, it's not as moisturizing, and I find that my lips become super chapped after 2-3 days of using it. Man, my love for Aquaphor goes on. The last two products are also spot treatments. The first one is the vitamin C product that I mentioned earlier that I used to use all the time, and I still use it, but only in very specific spots. So this is the Shaklee Youth Radiant C and E Serum. So these come in capsules now. In each little capsule is the serum, and again, this is 20% vitamin C, and this really does a great job of healing any scars you have. Specifically for me, any acne spots that I would pick at that wouldn't heal, this serum does such an amazing job of healing that quickly. But what I used to do is I would take it and I would just rub it all over my face because I had a lot of dots and a lot of spots and a lot of scars that I wanted to heal. And while it would heal those scars, because the vitamin C was in an oily substance, that substance would break me out. So that's why I switched over to using the vitamin C powder on a regular basis. But if I have a really big spot that just will not heal, I'll take that and I will just put it directly on the spot, nowhere else, and it'll heal it up super quickly. And then the other thing for acne, which I was very apprehensive using these because they looked a bit gimmicky to me, but now I will never go back. These are the Peace Out Acne Healing Dots with salicylic acid, vitamin A, and aloe vera. So these are basically these little sticker dots that you peel them off, you stick it on top of your zit. I'll do it after I'm done washing my face, and then I'll apply the rest of my skincare around the dot, and I'll sleep with it on, I'll leave it on as long as I possibly can, and then I'll remove it in the morning before I wash my face again. And I enjoy these dots for two reasons. One is I get these really large, deep, painful zits sometimes, and you can feel them coming. You're like, ooh, that bump is large. You can't extract it yet, but it's definitely there, and I find those are the ones that I really just pick at all the time, waiting for them to be extracted. And the majority of the time, the spot seems like it's no longer there, or it's come all the way to the surface and you're able to extract it quickly and it heals much faster. And then second off, because I pick at my zits a lot, if I have something like that, I can stick one of these on and I don't pick at it because it's covered. I can't pick at it. And I find that just the act of not picking at my zits helps so much. I know everyone tells you that, but it's such a bad habit and it's so hard to break. So I find that these stickers are fantastic for helping me break that habit. And again, it heals faster. I feel like it brings everything up to the surface. I thought they were gonna be gimmicky, but truly, they really work. I like them a lot. Okay guys, that's it. I rambled on for a while, mainly about Aquaphor. Can you tell that I love Aquaphor? Seriously, everyone needs to go out and buy Aquaphor. It's the best thing in the world. I hope that you guys found any of these products interesting, or hopefully I was able to give a little bit more insight on these products if you are looking into purchasing them yourself. If you have a skin type that's similar to me, let me know down below what products you guys really enjoy using. What are you doing to switch up your skincare going into these colder months if you do live in a place that's gonna be getting colder? I'd love to hear it, especially too if you have eczema or if you're prone for breakouts. I'd really love to hear what it is you're using. If you guys have any oil recommendations for acne prone skin, let me hear them because I'm here for it. I want to find an oil, especially for winter when my skin starts to get more dry. It's still oily, but it's dry. It's everything. Thanks guys for listening to me ramble. I'll have everything linked down below, and I will chat with you guys next time. Bye.